order to be healthy, you have to have a community that is healthy, where nutritious food is accessible, housing is safe, where water is trusted and fluoridated. An individual needs to be able to access the providers that they need from the very beginning of life so that they can get great preventive services, early diagnosis and treatment when issues do arise. Providers need to be compensated to care for the entire person, not just provide episodic care. And the system needs to be designed to support all of those pieces.
Children who experience homelessness are sick 4 times more often than their housed peers, and that's even if you adjust for income and things like that. Giving a family and children safe housing, it's going to affect their education, certainly their health, their employability, their ability to graduate, which also affects their health.
It's very difficult for some patients to get to the dentist for whatever reason. Mom or dad can't take off from work, or they don't have access to a car, or they don't have access to public transportation. Which then means that the child can't make it to the dentist, which then leads to an oral infection and 3 days of missed school because they then have to have a tooth extracted emergently.
Disparities are very real, and it is really important that we talk about issues of race and issues of income as they affect health. We need to understand how racism, how inequality, and how disparities are impacting the health of Virginians. We can't reach our mission of comprehensive healthcare that includes oral health if we are not acknowledging that very real issue in Virginia.
We have to take care of the community. We have to take care of people on the periphery, and probably more so and especially those that don't have the traditional access to good health care. Even more when you realize that some of these things could have been avoided and could be maintained, and some could be actually eradicated with lifestyle changes, like taking care of your mouth.
If you sit back and listen to community members when it comes to public health, a lot of them are advocates for the work that we do. They just do it in very personal ways. I think it's important that when we talk about tapping into voices that matter in communities, that we don't overlook those who have been quietly doing things for their neighbors or for their community members, or being voices at tables that traditionally they wouldn't have thought to be at.
I'm hopeful that systems are in place that are beginning to work to boost awareness for patients. And I'm very hopeful, as long as there are folk like Virginia Health Catalyst out there who are working hard to bring different disciplines together and to get them to start talking and to understanding each other's issues they may have. I think things are better now than they've been in a long time.